Hello everyone, hope you all are doing great. So today we'll do mosaic art. You people are familiar with mosaic art. So I'll quickly tell you what mosaic art is. So mosaic art is basically done with tiles, using tiles, ceramic tiles, and on walls or wooden panels, wooden surface. Okay, something quite hard which can handle the weight of the tile. Okay, so tiles are they have small pieces of tiles, and they are arranged in such a form that they form any object, any landscape, any picture, okay, anything, whatever the artist wants to make. So they are arranged with the help of fixing medium, okay, on surfaces, hard surfaces, which can bear the weight of the tile. So this is called mosaic art, MOSAIC, mosaic art. Okay, it's very easy, very fun. I hope you will enjoy this. So colors are limited, okay, not very limited, but yeah, limited. And drawing is also very simple. Try to take small size sheet, okay. So there are some basic rules which you have to follow in this. Firstly, take a small size paper. This is A4. If you want to take a smaller than A4, which is A5, you can go ahead with A5 size also, okay. Secondly, very light pencil drawing, okay, because we don't show the pencil marks, okay, when we color this mosaic art, we don't want pencil marks to be shown, okay. So either erase the pencil marks later or do very light drawing, so that you don't have to do double work. Third thing is, do not outline anything. Whatever we are drawing, we will specify that particular object. We are not going to specify these small blocks here, okay. So today we are going to make cup and saucer, okay. Very light drawing, no outline, take a smaller size sheet. This is A4. If you want to go with a little small size, then A4, preferably A5, but keep it if you are going with A5, keep it horizontal. Okay, keep your sheet horizontal if you're going with A5, as well as if you're going with A4, keep it horizontal. Okay, so let's start. First, we are going to draw. I'll draw a little dark, okay, so that it is visible. Drawing is very simple, okay. Now, just be careful with the steps which I am going to tell you after this drawing. It is very simple drawing, simple outlines. We are ready with our cup. Now we'll make saucer also. So just now please focus here. Now we are done. Okay, this is our drawing, random drawing. No need to use scale to make this cup, okay. No measurements required, nothing, just whatever you are able to draw with free hand, go ahead. Now what you have to take care of is, now so we are doing mosaic here, okay. So for mosaic, what we do, we take small pieces of tiles and we arrange them. So likewise, we are going to arrange our blocks, okay, with our pencil. So we'll start from this line, okay. Now we'll make these rectangular blocks here, not touching each other, but they can touch this line, this slanting line. They are not touching each other, but they can touch this slanting line. I'll just keep it a little narrow like this, okay. Now vertical, done. Now little wide squares. Again, these squares are not touching each other, neither these squares are touching my rectangles. So again, we are going to repeat this process. Rectangle blocks here. Please draw very light, okay. Don't put too much pressure on your pencil. Draw very light. Now again, squares. See, these squares are not even touching this part,
okay, not even touching this part, let them be like this only. Again,
to make squares, please don't keep on measuring, just draw freehand, draw as much freehand as you can, like this. Okay, now again we'll follow these rectangle blocks. Be careful, they should not touch each other. Okay, now again squares. So this way your cup, your saucer, everything. So now we are done with this part, right? Same ways we are going to do this handle here. Around this, we are going to make these rectangular blocks. They can touch this curved line, but they are not going to touch each other. I'll just quickly show you how it will look once it will be colored, so that you will get more wide idea. So it will look like this. So these rectangular blocks which you are making will be black. Okay, these shades of blue. Okay, this also shades of blue. Any shade of blue here, one or two or three, whatever, how many you want to keep, just keep. Okay, and then all over the background we are going to make these blocks. See, these blocks are not touching each other, so we just have to maintain this thing, and there is no outline here. No outlines, please. Okay, we are not going to specify each and every block. This is a particular object, this cup and saucer, which we want to show, not each and every block which we want to specify here. Okay, just this part. So this is absolutely visible, so we don't need to outline and make it more observed. So we are able to observe this, we are able to see this, we are able to see this clearly, so no need to specify it by making more outlines. Okay, so just color these blocks. You can make it more wide if you don't have space here. Okay, otherwise just change the shape of the inner line here, like this. Instead of squares, I'm just changing the shape or the size, whatever you are comfortable in. Same for this area. Okay, and once it will be completed, it will look very pretty, and you can frame it and put it in on your wall or kitchen, anywhere, like this. Okay, and see, we have this much space here, so we will cover this with different shapes, wide shapes. So this is our tea or coffee, whatever we want to present in our cup. Now again we are going to repeat the same procedure here. So just follow this. If your drawing will be perfect, then your coloring will be perfect. So try to focus on your drawing and once you are done with your drawing, then you can start coloring. Of course, you can start coloring. So these lines are black, okay, and the rest of the area is blue, and the background is of shades of yellow. Mediums which you can use here are watercolor pencils, color pencils, watercolors, poster colors, sketch pens, brush pens, wax crayons. Don't use oil pastels, because oil pastels will not give it a fine look. Okay, they will not give a little fine look as a sketch pen or brush pen or any other medium will give. Now once we are done with our object, Now we are going to fill the space with different big shapes here. Wherever necessary, you can add triangle. Suppose this area is there, add a triangle, no problem at all. Different shapes, but little bigger than this cup. Suppose we are using small squares here, so we'll use little bigger big squares here as compared to these, like this. See, randomly, but be careful that you don't leave too much of space in between two blocks. Okay, there should be like normal space left. Good white margin should be there, but not too much. Okay, so I have already shown you how your work will look like this. You have to draw these blocks here, shades of yellow for the background. Okay, so I'll tell you with this brush pen here, light. Okay, let's keep this line light, dark, light again, dark again. Now let's take dark blue. So dark blue. You can even use watercolors here. Okay, I'll show you with watercolor also. So I'll keep it here for your reference. Brown for this area. Okay. So this is brown for this area. So this can be your tea, your coffee, anything else. If you want to make, you can make. Try not to use too much of water. Otherwise, the paper will absorb all the water, and there will be not much pigment on the paper. Okay, so brown. Now for black, I use brush pen because these are very fine lines. You can even use sketch pen here. I'll just show it here, like this. Okay, so no block is touching each other. That's all you have to keep in mind. No block should touch each other. Whatever you're making, and once you are done, if there are pencil marks here. Suppose there's this pencil mark here, okay, and this cup and this saucer here, this handle here. So just erase them. Wherever you are able to see these, wherever these are visible, just erase them. Okay. Mediums, any mediums, no outlines, very light pencil. Take a small size paper, don't go for your art file size sheets. Okay, if you are having art files, then just fold the paper and just do it on the half side. Horizontally, okay. Horizontally, and that's it. You will be done with your mosaic art. Watercolors, poster colors, acrylic colors. Don't use acrylic colors for now. Brush pens, sketch pens, watercolor pencils, pencil colors, wax crayons. Don't use oil pastels. Okay. Anything you can use here. Shades of yellow. So here is light lemon yellow, dark yellow, yellow with white, yellow with brown, okay, yellow, brown, white. Like this you can create as many shades as possible. Blue, blue, normal blue, blue with white, that's it, and then black and then brown. Limited colors, but very fun work to do. I hope you all will enjoy. So this is not completed. I will complete this part, okay. So it will look something like this. Just don't see this part here. So once it will be completed, it will look very pretty. I hope you all will enjoy and you'll share the pictures with me. Take your time, do it nicely, and hope to see your work soon. Thank you so much.